Good morning, all of you. Today in our topic, we have to discussing combination of capacitors. See, yesterday we are discussing very well, that is energy stored in a capacitor and the impact of the dielectric on a energy stored in the capacitor. Okay. But today we are going to learn about the combination of capacitors. These are very huge topic, which is very commonly asking in JEE and NEET. There are simple circuits and you have to calculate the resultant capacitance in various different easy and multiple types of circuits. Okay, so this now we are going to study about the combination of capacitors. Combination of capacitors. So what are the combinations of capacitors are available? There are two combination of capacitors are there. First one, it is the series combination, and the second one, it is the parallel combination. Series and parallel. So these two combinations are used to change the resultant capacitance in a given circuit. To change the resultant capacitance in a given circuit, then you have to use these two combinations. So here, what is the series combination of capacitors? If a few capacitors are taken in one order, these are all the capacitors which I drawn here. This is the capacitor C1, capacitor C2 and capacitor C3. Let it be, it is enough. And there is a battery. So this is minus and positive. And here, so this is the process of the passing of charge. So here in this, the series combination is called as, this is the first plate of the first capacitor, second plate of the first capacitor, first plate of the second capacitor, second plate of the second capacitor, first plate of the third capacitor, second plate of the third capacitor, right? The second plate of the first capacitor is connected to the first plate of the second capacitor, and the second plate of the second capacitor is connected to the first plate of the third capacitor. Then the first plate of the first capacitor and the last plate of the second plate of the third capacitor are connected to the battery. So this combination is known as the series combination. So when you are, all of you are stretch our hands and one by one will be touches with our hands. I am the first one and there is a last one, the left hand of the last one, the right hand of the first one should be combined. So that is the series combination of the capacitors here. So here in this, so this is the battery where voltage is supplying, potentially supplying here. And here, the charge on the capacitors is always same. Q1 is equal, Q2 is equal, Q3 it is equal, Q. Okay. And the potential of the first capacitor is V1. The potential of the second capacitor is V2. The potential of third capacitor is V3. Because of here, from the charge is moving from here to capacitor C1, there is potential V1. And here to from capacitor C2, there is V2. So the potential should be increases here because of the distance will be increases. What is meant by potential? The work done to bringing a unit positive charge into an electric field. Here, the C1, C2 capacitors are different distances. At first, there is C1 capacitor, it has less work done. And second one, there is C2 capacitor, it has more work done compared to the first capacitor. And similarly, as well as. So here the net potential here in this circuit V is equal where it is V1 plus V2 plus V3 here. V1 plus V2 plus V3. By the definition of the capacitance, we have to write that V is equal Q by C here. V is equal Q by C. This is the basic equation for the potential of a capacitor. Right? So let us see here. You have to write that. We have to find that V1 value, V2 value, V3 value. V1 is the potential on the capacitor C1. Potential on the capacitor C1 should be written as, from this equation, C1 it is equal, what is that? Charge by capacity. What is charge here? Q1 charge. This is Q1 charge. And what is capacitor? V it is equal. Here, V1 it is equal. Q by C1. So Q1 is equal, already you know that Q1 is equal to Q. It is Q by C1. And the potential on the second capacitor V2 is equal Q2 by C2. It is equal Q by C2. Because of Q1 is equal, Q2 is equal, Q3 is equal, Q. And the potential on the third capacitor V3 is equal Q3 by C3 here. It is equal Q by C3. Right? So, from this equation, you know very well about the V value, it is Q by C, V1 it is equal Q by C1, V2 is equal Q by C2. So, all these equations are substituted in this equation. From V is equal V1 plus V2 plus V3, you can write that Q by C is equal, so this is Q by C here, it is equal, what is that? Q by C1 plus Q by C2 and plus Q by C3 here. So here Q is common. There Q will be common. Here 1 by C is equal to 1 by Q will be common here. 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3 here. The Q will be gets cancelled. So here the capacitance, the resultant capacitance is here, that is 1 by C is equal 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. Okay, so this is the resultant capacitance where the capacitors are connected in series combination. What is that combination? Series combination. Okay, so here the reciprocal of the resultant capacitance, the reciprocal of the resultant capacitance is equal to the reciprocal of the capacities of all the individual capacitors. All the individual capacitors. The reciprocal of the resultant capacitance is equal to the reciprocal of all the individual capacitance of a capacitors. Right? If two capacitors are connected in a series combination, then what we have? How we can find that? So if two capacitors are connected in series, so this is the capacitor C1 and C2. So here, what is the resultant capacitance here? So we need to find here, it is 1 by C is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 here. Where 1 by C is equal C1 C2, C1 plus C2 here. Where C is equal C1 C2 by C1 plus C2 here. So this is the resultant capacitance where two capacitors are connected in series combination. Clear? So this is the combination. In the series combination, the charge on the capacitors are equal. The charge on the capacitors are equal. But the potential is different. The potential, it is nothing but the work done to bringing the unit positive charge from infinity to the field. So here the charge is bringing into the capacitor C1, there is some work done should be acts, and one more work done should be acting to bringing the charge in from to the capacitor C2, and another work done should be act here, the charge will be bringing to the capacitor C3. Okay, so then that's why the potential should be changed as up to C1 it is V1, and up to C2 that is V2, up to C3 it is V3. The total potential is equal V1 plus V2 plus V3. So from this equation you can write that the basic potential of the capacitor, it should be V is equal Q by C. Let it be find the potential on the capacitor C1. So V1 is equal Q1 by C1, it is Q by C, because of Q1 is also equal to the Q. The total charge on the circuit is equal, is same, is constant, remains same, but the potential will be different to individual capacitors. Okay, so if two capacitors are connected in the series combination, then C is equal C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. So this is the resultant capacitance of a capacitors in series combination. Right, now let us see parallel combination. So how we can derive the resultant capacitance in parallel combination? So what is meant by a parallel combination of capacitors? Let us see here. So this is a capacitor, this is a capacitor, and this is a capacitor having two plates here, and this is a one more capacitor. Okay, this is the first plate of the capacitor, and this is the first plate of the capacitor, and this is the first plate of the capacitor. So all are first plate of the capacitors. So this is capacitor C1 having capacity C1, C2 and C3. These are the three capacitors. And this is the second plate of the capacitor, first capacitor, second plate of the first capacitor, second plate of the second capacitor, and second plate of the third capacitor. Right? So here, what I am saying it is here, that is, all the first plates of the capacitors are connected at one point, all the second plates of the capacitors are connected at another point. So these two points are connected now with a battery. So this is the parallel combination. This is positive and negative. So this is the charge moving. So here the potential V. So here at this point, all the capacitors are connected to each other. So at once, if Q charge will be moving in this direction, and this Q will be sharing to the three capacitor. For suppose this is Q1 and it is Q2 and it is Q3. And one more charge given to the capacitors, another charge will be moving in this side, in this way. And here this Q will be passes separated to the all those capacitor, that is Q1, Q2, Q3. So at once you have to do the work. At once you have to do the work. There is the charge will be separated to the or sharing to the all the individual capacitors. Okay. So here the potential is equal. Potential is always remains constant. Okay. But the charge is unchanges. Charge is unchanged. So hence here the potential V it is equal, V1 it is equal, V2 it is equal, V3. So there is no need to separately doing work here, because of all the capacitors are connected here. At once you have to do the work, they can be getting the charge, because of all the points are connected at single point. Right? But the charge is unchanges. So the charge Q it is equal, resultant charge is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. So here the charge Q it is equal separated into Q1, Q2, Q3. So that is Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. Okay. So from the definition of the charge, capacitor charge is equal CV. Q is equal CV. So from the capacity definition, Q is equal CV. Now we have to find that the charge on the capacitor C1. Q1 it is equal C1 V1. But V1 it is equal, V1 is equal V. Therefore, it is C1 V here. And similarly, capacitance charge on the capacitor C2, Q2 it is equal C2 V2. Where V2 is equal V. Hence, it is C2 V. The charge on the third capacitor Q3 it is equal C3 V3. Where V3 is equal V. Then it is equal C3 V. From these values, you have to substitute here. From this equation, you can get the resultant capacitance. So where Q is equal, what is Q is equal? CV. And Q1 is equal? Q1 is equal C1V. And Q2 is equal C2V. And Q3 is equal C3V. The V will be common here. CV it is equal V into C1 plus C2 plus C3 here. Where V, V cancelled out. Therefore, C is equal C1 plus C2 plus C3. So, this is the resultant capacitance in the parallel combination. In the parallel combination. So, this is the parallel combination of the capacitors. Where the parallel combination of the capacitors, the resultant capacitance is equal to the capacitances of the individual capacitors. So, this is the C1 capacitor. This is the first capacitor having the C1 capacity. Second capacitor having the C2 capacity. Third capacitor having the C3 capacity. The resultant capacity or capacitance is equal to the sum of all the individual capacitances of a capacitors in the circuit. In the series combination, the reciprocal of the resultant capacitance is equal to the reciprocal of the sum of reciprocal of the all the individual capacitors of a capacitances. That is 1 by C it is equal 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 up to 1 by Cn if there is n capacitors. So here there is n capacitors are connected in the parallel combination there C1 plus C2 plus C3 up to Cn. If two capacitors are connected in the parallel, for example, here there is a capacitor C1 and here there is a capacitor C2. Now the resultant capacitance here, so this is C1 and this is C2, these two are the parallel combination. So whereas C it is equal C1 plus C2 here. So this is the parallel combination of a capacitor. In parallel combination, the potential should be constant. So here you have to remember the point, potential same, charge unchanged, charge is changed, okay. But in series combination, charge remains same, potential changes. Okay, so this is the clear idea about the series and parallel combinations. By these combinations, we have to do some numericals. Let us see. Now, let us see. This is the question here. There is two capacitors. First capacitor is having 6 microfarad and second one it is the 3 microfarad. And this is the battery. There is 12 volts of potential. Find first one. What is that? Equivalent capacitance. And the second one, charge on each capacitor. Okay. Third one, potential on each. And fourth one, that is energy stored in 3 microfarad capacitor. How much energy has it storing? Let us see. At first we have to see equivalent capacitance of this circuit. So here there are two capacitors are there in the series combination. Okay. So in the series combination there are two capacitors are there. Let it be C1 and C2. Then the resultant capacitance in series combination, already you know that C it is equal C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. Okay. So how it will be? So this is C1 capacitor and this is C2 capacitor. C1 and C2, whereas 1 by C it is equal 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 here. 1 by C is equal C1 C2 C1 plus C2. You need C it is equal C1 C2 by C1 plus C2 here. Okay, so this is the formula. Where C is equal, what is C1 here? 6 microfarad into C2. how much it is 3 microfarad, 6 plus 3, it is equal 18 by 9, here it is 2 microfarad. So this is the resultant capacitance. So how much it is 2 microfarad. Okay. And now we have to find charge on each capacitor. So what is charge here? The charge it is Q is equal. Charge Q it is equal. Charge Q is equal to CV. So C it is the resultant capacitance here. V it is already you know 12 volts. Therefore Q it is equal 2 into 12 volts. It is equal 24. What is that? Micro coulombs. Micro coulombs. Charge it is in coulomb. Micro coulomb. How much it is? 24. It is 24 micro coulombs. So this is the charge. This is the charge. Okay. And potential on each capacitor. Potential on each capacitor. So here, this is the resultant capacitance of 2 micro coulomb, 2 microfarad, and the voltage on potential it is on 12 volts. Okay. So charge it is equal, Q is equal, CV. From C is equal 2 into volt, it is 12. Okay. So this is the total circuit. For the individual of the capacitors, for the individual of the capacitors, how we can write that? So how we can write that? It is equal the potential of each capacitor from the potential V is equal to Q by C here. How much it is Q? 24 and C it is equal C resultant here. What is C resultant here? 2. It is equal V is equal Q by C. C it is equal 12 volts. So this is the 12 volts. Okay. Okay, right. So from the first capacitor, it is equal. How much the potential is here? So V it is equal to Q by C1 here. So Q it is nothing but 24 micro coulomb by C1 nothing but 6 microfarad. It is equal 4 volts. So here 4 volts is there. 4. So this is 4 volts. And the second one, V it is equal Q by C2, it is nothing but Q, how much it is? 24 by C2 is equal 3, it is equal to 8 volts. So this is 8 volts. The total is 4 plus 8, it is equal 12 volts. Okay. Okay. So this is the pattern you have to find that energy stored in 3 microfarad, that is energy is equal U is equal of CV square, of CV square. So how much capacity here you have to take in? 1 by 2 into 3 into V is how much? So equivalent the voltage it is equal 12. So V it is the, so on the 3 microfarad the voltage it is equal 8. 8 square it is equal 64. It is equal 32. It is equal how much? 3 into 32. 96 joules. 96 joules. Okay. So this is the pattern. You have to find the charge and equivalent capacity and the potential and energy stored in the individual capacitors. Okay. See, let us see here. Here there are three capacitors are there which are connected in the parallel combination, right? So this is the potential 4 volts. Now find equivalent capacitance, and the second one charge on each capacitor. Okay. And third one it is potential difference, and fourth one energy stored in 1 microfarad capacitor, right? So let us see first one, equivalent capacitance. In the parallel combination, the equivalent capacitance C is equal to the sum of all the individual capacitors C1 plus C2 plus C3, where C is equal, what is C1 here, 1 microfarad, 1 plus 2 plus 3 here, it is 6 microfarad here. That is the equivalent equivalent capacitance, 6 mu of, it is resultant, right? The second one, charge on each capacitor. In the parallel combination, the potential should be same, but the charge on each capacitor is different. Okay? So now let us find the potential. The potential, it is equal. What is the potential? How much it is here? 4 volts is common at all. So this is potential. Okay? So now let us find the capacity, the charge on the capacitor Q1. Q1 is equal C1V. C1 it is equal how much? 1 into V it is equal 4. So this is equal 4 coulombs. And the charge on the capacitor C2, Q2 is equal C2V. It is equal, what is C2 here? 2 microfarad into, so here micro coulomb. This is a micro coulomb. 2 into voltage, it is potential, it is the 4. It is 8 micro coulomb. Because of, in already we seen that the potential is remains same. V is equal, V1 is equal, V2 is equal, V3 here. Right. The charge is changes. Q3 is equal C3V here. From capacitor C3, it is equal 3 into V, it is equal 4. It is 12 micro coulomb. So these are the charges on each capacitor. So here the charge, it is 4 micro coulomb. It is 8 micro coulomb. So this is the Q2. This is the Q1. This is the Q3. How much here? 12 micro coulomb. Okay. Now the energy stored in 1 microfarad capacitor. Energy, it is equal, U, it is equal 1 by 2 CV square. So how much capacitor? It is 1 microfarad. It is 1 by 2 into 1 into V square here. It is 4 square. It is nothing but 16 here. It is 8 joules. Okay. You have to remember here one thing. In the parallel combination, the potential remains same. That is 4 volts. In the series combination, the charge remains same. That is the important point you have to remember here for doing the numericals. Okay, clear? So let us see one more circuit. Now let us see the circuit. So here, this is point, the capacitance of the capacitor here 12 microfarad, 3 microfarad, 2 microfarad, whereas 20 microfarad. So here, find the resultant capacitance between A and B. So here, where is A and B? So here we need to choose a point A and a point B here. Okay, this is the A and B, right? So how much resultant capacitance has here? So we have to observe here, these two capacitors are parallel to each other. From these two capacitors are parallel to each other. The parallel combination of the capacitors, you can write C is equal C1 plus C2, where 3 plus 2, 5 microfarad. So this circuit should be, so this is the circuit here, A, and this is 12 microfarad, and this is, where is here, 5 microfarad, where the resultant, and another capacitor is here 20 microfarad. So this is the 20 microfarad, and there is the end of B here. So this is 20 microfarad. So now let us observe these three capacitors. These three are in series combination. The second end of the first end, second end of the first end, and first end both are connected to each other. That is the series combination. In series combination, the resultant capacitance 1 by C is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3 here. So here C is equal to C1 plus C2. 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. This is one capacitor. This is one capacitor. Okay. So here 1 by C is equal. What is 1 by C1 here? 1 by 12 plus 1 by C2. 1 by 5 and plus 1 by 20. Okay. So we need to find the LCM value. How much LCM is here? That is 60 is the LCM here. 60. It is 5 times of 12 and 12 times of 5 and 3 times of 5. So this is 17 plus 20 by 60. It is equal 1 by 3. 1 by C is equal 1 by 3. C is equal 3 microfarad. 3 microfarad. 1 by C is equal to 1 by 3. 1 by C is equal to 1 by 3, where C is equal 3 microfarad. So here it is 3 microfarad. So this is the method you have to solve here. Clear? So here there are two capacitors are each and parallel to each other. For the parallel combination, C is equal C1 plus C2. 3 plus 2 is equal 5 microfarad. And these three capacitors are looks like series combination. From the series combination, this is series. Right? Series combination 1 by C is equal. The reciprocal of the resultant capacitance is equal to the sum of reciprocals of individual capacitances. Right? So let us given that we have to find the C is equal 1 by 3. 1 by C is equal 1 by 3. C is equal 3 microfarad. So right, this is the process you have to find the resultant capacitance where you have to give in some circuits. So in next class we have to do more numericals with the complicated circuits. So until that, you have to watch our channel and subscribe our channel, like, share, comment to and share to your friends. Thank you.